Good morning, SUC family, in the words of my friend Alan and Yoni. Hope you're doing well, church. Can you believe it? It's been 40 days since we celebrated Resurrection Sunday. Do you remember that beautiful sunrise down at the beachfront? Do you remember how at the church service here we greeted each other and Murray said, "Christ is risen," and we responded, we said, "He is risen indeed." Do you remember how we worshipped and how we enjoyed and celebrated that day? Ah, what a day. What a wonderful day. And we get to enjoy that every Sunday as we gather. We enjoy and celebrate the resurrection. Remember how the cross, his death and his resurrection, has really changed our future forever. But today we celebrate 40 days after that resurrection, Ascension Day. And this is the day where God decided it was the right time for Jesus to ascend to heaven, to be glorified, to be enthroned and return to the Father. The Bible speaks of this event from the Old Testament to the New. It wasn't an unplanned event, friends. It was planned. In Daniel, in the Old Testament, he prophesied and he said, "I saw in the night visions, and behold, with the clouds of heaven, there came one like a son of man, and he came to the Ancient of Days and was presented before him. And to him was given dominion and glory and a kingdom, that all peoples, nations, and languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion, which shall not pass away, and his kingdom one that shall not be destroyed." In the New Testament, in John 20, verse 17, Jesus himself says, "Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Wow, Jesus calls us his children, that his God is our God, his Father is our Father. How wonderful. So let's read the Ascension story together in Mark 16, verse 15 to 20. And take special notice of the very first line and Jesus' instruction to his disciples. He said to them, "Go into all the world and preach the gospel to all creation. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved, but whoever does not believe will be condemned. And these signs will accompany those who believe. In my name they will drive out demons, they will speak in new tongues, they will pick up snakes with their hands, and when they drink deadly poison, it will not hurt them at all. They will place their hands on sick people, and they will get well." After the Lord Jesus had spoken to them, he was taken up into heaven and he sat at the right hand of God. Then the disciples went out and preached everywhere, and the Lord worked with them and confirmed his word by the signs that accompanied it. Jesus' ascension completed the Father's work, the Father's mission, and he now rules with all authority and intercedes with all sympathy as our mediator and high priest. What does this mean for us as believers today? Firstly, I'd encourage us to remember that Jesus is presently ruling and reigning as King, and that he remains active and engaged in our world and in our lives. Yesterday, I was speaking with our garden assistant here at the church, Pardon, and we were talking about this hectic flu that's going around. And, you know, I was saying, "Ooh, I just don't want to get this flu, I'm so scared." And he said to me, "Don't worry, God is in control." And I said, "Yes, you're right, Pardon." A good reminder. And so let us remember today, God is in control, that he is ruling, he is reigning, that he is active and engaged in our lives. We're not alone, friends. Remember, don't forget that on this beautiful Ascension Day. Remember is the first one. Secondly, to go. Jesus gave us an instruction. We have a job to do. Go into all the world and preach the gospel to all creation. Friends, know that your labors in Christ is not in vain. Jesus does the work. We just need to be faithful. Thirdly, I'd like to encourage us to take heart. To take heart today. Jesus is not indifferent to our struggles, friends. He has endured great suffering and is the most merciful and sympathetic counselor and mediator. Take your cares to the ascended Lord who hears your prayers and can respond with all of heaven's authority. Finally, the fourth point, hope. Hope in a glorious future. The ascended Lord will return as judge and king. He will abolish injustice. This injustice that we endure, friends, he will abolish it. He will end suffering. He will destroy death and set up his kingdom of truth, righteousness, and love. And best of all, we will be with our King forever. How wonderful. Let's pray together. Jesus, we thank you for the cross. We thank you for the empty tomb. We thank you for the completed work on earth and that you rule and reign in heaven. We praise you because your death and resurrection secured our forgiveness, justification, and reconciliation with you. Help us, Lord, as we work for you every day, being your hands and feet on earth and continuing the mission of Jesus with the help of your wonderful Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen.